Today, I'm going to explain the movie called Perfume from 2006. This movie was based on a German novel named Perfume, The Story of a Murderer, written by Patrick Susskind. Some legendary people came to Earth for some legendary purpose. Exactly like this, a man born in this world with the world's best sense of smell to make us feel the best of perfumes. This man controlled a whole kingdom with the smell of his perfume. He got the recognition as an angel even after killing people. At the beginning of the movie, we saw that a man named John Baptiste is locked in a prison. He was with chains, and he was dragged outside. Many people were standing and screaming outside. They were calling him a murderer. He was hated by everyone. He was sentenced to death in front of the people. It was not just any normal sentence of death. His hands and legs will be broken first, and then he will be hanged. Everyone became so happy with this decision. All of them were celebrating it. Who is this John Baptiste? What was his crime? Why does everyone hate him so much? To know all these answers, we have to go back and see a flashback. We saw that the time was 1738. The place was Paris. The grossest and unclean place in Paris was the fish market. We saw a female fish vendor here, and she was pregnant. Suddenly, she felt pain and she gave birth to her baby. John Baptiste was born in the most badly smelling place in beautiful Paris. Before him, his mom gave birth to 4 more kids, but some of them were dead and some of them disabled. His mom threw them into the river. This baby was also born unconscious, so she was about to throw him away as well. But he was not just any ordinary kid. He had the most powerful sense of smell. He had the power to describe and analyze every possible smell in this world. The baby could not tolerate all the bad smells around him, and he cried. People around him came there, and then his mom could not throw him away. She ran away from there, but then his mom was sentenced to death for this crime. John Baptiste had some power that he was with someone, then they would have everything they need, but when he left them, somehow they would die. They took the baby to an orphanage. There was not enough space in this orphanage. That's why the other kids tried to kill this new baby. But then the caretaker of the orphanage saw it and saved the kid. But this did not mean that she loved kids. She was dependent on these kids to live her life. She would sell them in different industries when they got a little older. The situation in the orphanage was so piteous. They were living their life in so much misery and pain. When they took John to the orphanage, the other kids realized that he was different from them. He was special. Jean grew up. He didn't talk to anyone until he turned 5. When the other kids were busy playing games, Jean would practice with his sense of smell. He would feel everything around him with the smell. His power of smell was so powerful that if someone throws something at him, he could catch it even without looking at it. When Jean turned 13, the lady sold him to the leather industry. But the caretaker lady also died after she sold John. She died at the hand of some pickpocketers. John was the victim of beating and insults in the leather industry. In that leather industry, the workers had to work so hard that they could not live more than 5 years while working there. But only John was alive. John worked in that industry for more than 5 years, which means John was different from everyone else. Something very special was in him, which was helping him to stay alive. Once, his boss took him to the city to sell leather. It was the first time he came to the city. He lived in a very gross and unclean environment, but now he could smell nice things in the city. While smelling the good smell, he came to a perfume store. Then he smelled the most popular perfume at the time. After that, he smelled another perfume, which made him go crazy over it. He was so fascinated by it that he started to follow it. The smell was coming from the body of a girl who was a fruit seller. The beautiful girl noticed that Jean was following her, so she showed him some fruit and asked him if he wants to buy some. But Jean does not want anything except a good smell. He started smelling the girl's hand. The girl got scared of this strange behavior and ran away from him. Jean smelled her body and now he was following her. At some point he found her. When he was smelling her body, the girl started screaming. But then Jean put his hand on her mouth so that she could not scream anymore, and then started smelling her body. But the girl died because he was holding her breath for so long. Jean didn't realize that he had killed the girl. but he had no regret at all. The only relation he has is with good perfumes. He can do anything for a good perfume. He doesn't care about anything as long as he gets a good perfume. But after the girl died, the smell from her body was going away. John got worried. He does not lose the smell. That night, he did not sleep at all. He was thinking about how he can store the smell from this girl's body. One of the most famous perfume makers of that city was Baldini. He was so famous one day, but now he lost his fame. He was not able to sell his perfume because of the new perfume makers. He tried to make new perfumes from new formulas, but he failed. He also tried to figure out the formula of the most famous perfume of that time, but he could not succeed. On that day, Jean Baptiste came to his shop to deliver leather. Jean smelled the perfume of Amour Ancique from his body and told him that he can make it for him. He also told him that his nose is the best nose of Paris. First, Baldini did not believe him, but then he gave him a chance. Jean made a better perfume than Amour Ancique for Baldini. Baldini smelled it and he felt like it was the best moment of his life. Jean told him that if he keeps him to his shop, then he can make better perfumes than this one. He just needs to teach him how to store perfume. Baldini bought Jean from the leather dealer. But same as before, this leather dealer also died after selling Jean. Jean made some of the best perfumes with new formulas for Baldini. Baldini got back his fame with these perfumes. Baldini taught him so many things about perfume. He told him that a perfume has three levels. Each level has four notes. You need 12 notes to make a good perfume. If the perfume is a house, then these levels are the walls of that house. And the notes are the bricks of those walls. There is a saying that there is a 13th note. If you use this note, then you can make the best perfume out of it. The smell of this perfume would hypnotize everyone. It can make you feel like you are heaven. The perfume will be this much powerful. Jean was listening to him carefully, and maybe he was thinking that one day he will make a perfume like this. Jean wanted to learn about storing perfume from Baldini. He wanted to know that if he gets a good smell from something, then how can he store it, so that he never loses it. Baldini taught him a way of doing it. He showed him how to extract the perfume from 10,000 roses and store it. Baldini made a machine. He boils the roses here and stores the steam coming out of the roses. And the perfume from those roses comes out. After the flower, Jean tried to extract the smell of some other things. One night, Baldini saw that Jean was crying. Jean said that Baldini had lied to him. You cannot store every smell in this way. He could not store the smell of iron and other things. Jean wants to store the smell of anything and everything. Baldini saw that he had used his cat as well. He tried to extract the perfume from the cat's body. Baldini got angry at him and said that you can't extract smell from a living body like this. And then Jean fainted there after hearing this. He was getting sick after getting to know that he cannot extract smell from someone's body. He must extract the smell from body. He must learn a way to extract the smell from someone's body. Baldini got so worried after Jean became sick, because his business was dependent on Jean. Jean asked him for another ways to extract smell from a living body. Baldini said that he can melt the fat from any creature and extract the smell, but he does not know how to do this. But if he goes to Greece, then he can learn it. Jean got prepared to go there. Baldini let him go in exchange for 100 perfumes. Baldini also wrote a letter for him so that he can get a job there and learn the technique. Baldini was so happy to get 100 formulas. But same as before, Baldini died after Jean went far from him. His house collapsed and he died. Jean was going to a new city. He felt freedom for the first time in his life. He was no servant to anyone. He was going to Greece through the mountains. He stayed some days in a cave. One night, he dreamed about that fruit seller girl. The girl was near him, but she could not feel him, could not see him. Jean woke up and started to smell his own body. He noticed that his body has no smell. That's why the girl was not able to see him. The man who had the most powerful nose and sense of smell, who can make any kind of perfume or smell, does not have any smell of his own. Jean became sad about it. He thought that he has no value. That's why he decided to make the best perfume of the world and show them his value. While entering Greece, he felt that smell once again, that he felt from that fruit seller girl. This smell was coming from a girl named Laura. Jean went to her house by following the smell. Laura was the daughter of one of the richest men, Anthony. Jean started working for a lady named Arnulfi. He was learning about two ways to extract smell from animal fat. Jean wanted to make the best perfume in this world, and he was ready to do anything for it. He can go anywhere for it. He has nothing but perfume in his top priority list. And as a result, he killed a girl with good smell and then boiled her body. But still, he failed to extract the smell from her. And then he tried to do it with a second method. For this, he hired a prostitute. He covered her body with animal fat. The prostitute got scared after seeing this. At a certain point, she disagreed. She gave his money and told him to go away. But then Jean killed her too. He covered her body in animal fat to store it. And then he scraped out the animal fat from her body and boiled it. This time he was able to extract the smell from her body. And then Jean made a set of 13 bottles, as Baldini told him. He will make the best perfume of the world by completing this set. And for all of these 13 bottles, he needs 13 bodies of girls. One night, Laura throws a party for her birthday. Jean came there. Laura was playing hide and seek in the party. Then Jean was about to attack Laura, but then someone came there, so that he could not kill her. But Jean kidnapped two twin sisters from that party. He extracted perfume from them and filled the first bottle. He would hide these dead bodies in some places of the city. The people of the city were so scared about it. The government ordered a curfew in the city. Everyone started to lock their female people in their house. Laura's father was also tense about his daughter. He realized that this killer was targeting the beautiful girls and killing them for a special reason. And his daughter was the most beautiful girl of the city. Jean Baptiste had filled 12 of his bottles by killing 12 girls. Now he only needed one body to fill up the last bottle, and he would kill Laura to fill it up. The church called a meeting for the 12 murders. Everyone was very angry and sad. They wanted to get rid of it. And then they received the news. Someone has surrendered, and he said that he's the killer. Everyone got so happy after hearing it, and they started celebrating about it. But Anthony didn't agree with them. He investigated it and said that he was not the killer. The man said that he would kill the girls and cut off their hair, and then sexually torture them. But the dead bodies had no sign of sexual torture on them. The killer killed them with passion. But no one agreed with Anthony. Everyone was so happy, but Anthony left the town with his daughter. But while they were getting out of the town, Jean got her smell. Jean followed the smell and went to another city with them. On the other side, the cat of that prostitute pulled out her clothes from Jean's room, and then the people around his house came to his room and found 12 clothes of the 12 girls. The police were searching for Jean, but Jean was not there. He was with Laura and her father. Anthony went to a hotel and he would lock his daughter in a room always, and he would always keep the key with him. One night, Jean entered that hotel, he took the key and went to Laura's room, and he killed her. And he filled the 13th bottle with her body. The next day in the morning, Anthony found his daughter dead in her room. He became very sad and started crying. On the other hand, Jean had his 13th perfume. He mixed it with the other 12 perfumes, and he completed the best perfume in the world, which was kind of impossible to make. And then the police came there. They arrested Jean. And then, the story goes back to the beginning of the movie, where we saw Jean and he was sentenced to death. After 2 days, he will be hanged. And that day came. Not just the people of that town, many people from outside the town came there to watch him die. To watch this iconic murderer. The guards went to take out Jean. And then Jean opened his perfume bottle. And then all the guards went unconscious from the perfume. And then we saw that Jean was dressed as a prince, and he came to the stage of beheading. The executioner was fascinated by the perfume on his body. He lost his mind and said that he was an angel, and he was not a criminal. And then Jean spread the smell of his perfume with a piece of cloth. Everyone around him became fascinated by the smell of it. They felt so happy as if they were in heaven. They forgot everything of this world. They forgot about all the discrimination and differences, and they fell in love with each other. They started to think that Jean was an angel. Even Laura's father came to him and pledged himself to Jean. He asked Jean for forgiveness. Jean saw all of this love and felt love for the first time. He closed his eyes and remembered about that fruit seller girl. He could have loved her and gotten love by her. He could have the smell of her body for the rest of his life. He has killed so many girls, including that fruit seller girl, for perfume and smell. John got so sad while thinking about all of this, and he left. He was the owner of a weapon that was the most powerful weapon in the world. He can control any nation or country with the power he has. He can be the king and take over the whole kingdom if he wants. But he didn't do anything like this. People were loving him, praising him, because of the perfume. When the perfume will end, he will have no power left over them. He does not want this fake love and respect. That's why he does not want this anymore. He started to think himself as a criminal. Maybe he has fulfilled his destiny, but he has lost the track of his life. He has no hope left for his life. He kept walking and reached the smelly fish market, where he was born. Then he poured the whole bottle of perfume on his head. Everyone was fascinated by the smell of it. They jumped on his body. They were smelling his body so much that they tore his body apart. The next day in the morning, there was nothing but John's clothes left on that place. And just like that, the best perfume maker in the world, the owner of the most sensitive nose, the murderer, died. And the last drop of that perfume dropped on the road. Maybe this is why Paris is called the City of Love and Romance.